pass those out. This survey will assess your knowledge and awareness on concepts relating to lifestyle and your current understanding of yourself. Keep in mind that there are no right or wrong answers, so you don't have to worry about that. Your participation to this research is voluntary, so you can stop taking it at any point. You won't be penalized if you skip any questions. You must be 19 or older to take this survey, so if you are below that age, just stick around and wait until everybody is finished. It should take you about 5 minutes or so. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask me. A really difficult question for some of us to answer.
what I took down is what was I, you know, disease and accident. Because I was accident prone. So anyway, but all those subsequent questions seems to be pretty logical. Have I joined? I'm going to doctors.
Including dentists?
Yeah, dentists. That's all my mom. Saturday Night Live, the eggshell people who are always going over the backwards, you know. I'm such a backwards.
Yeah. I thought I'd put an MTSD card. I'm glad I brought an MTSD card, you guys. I'm just like, I'm very sorry. I'm glad
yeah, they probably know.
Okay, we're going to move on. So, like, these have
the conscientious objector. 3 hours.
The goal of this exercise was to become more self-aware and to examine what truly makes you unique. I wanted you to realize your strengths and the good positive qualities that you have and how you can strengthen them and use them to your advantage. I also wanted you to realize what your drawbacks are, because we all have them, and I wanted you to think about what you could do to improve them. And finally, I wanted you to realize that you are never stuck. We have the ability to learn new things. You have the ability to overcome your fears. We are always growing. Earlier I mentioned how important it is to tap into each of your elements. And today, since we're focusing on the mind, I'd like to share with you this video on mental strength. She married a man named Lincoln and bought a house. She thought she had her whole life figured out until one day her mother had a brain aneurysm and passed away. 3 years later, her husband collapsed and had a life-ending heart attack. She became a widow at 26 years old and had no mother to go to for comfort. Fast forward a couple years after, she remarried, she bought a new house, had a new job, whole fresh new start. And then her father-in-law was diagnosed with terminal cancer. So keep that in mind.
Had terminal cancer. And I started to think, why do these things always have to
in